Hello everyone! In this video you will see me make an acrylic flower again. I'm also going to use the reverse dip technique. And I want to make a series of flowers on some smaller canvases. And this will be the first one. All different colors for the other two. But this is the first of the series, so for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of acrylic, in this case, different techniques, but also resin, mixed media and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell, because that way you don't miss anything. Also select all, because it's all about the right choices to click the notification bell. So I already started pouring a white layer onto my small canvas. It's a round canvas, it's 20 centimeters, so not that large. And I want to make a series, what I already mentioned, all different colors, but this one will get mainly blue colors and also a nice bright magenta color. So the mix I'm using for the pouring medium is Friona Arts Mix. I'm using a primer 20% and an acrylic binder 80%. And that's the pouring medium. And when I mix the paints, I'm using one part paint and four parts pouring medium. So the first color is a nice color. It's a very dark blue. It's from Amsterdam Acrylic. It's the Prussian Blue. So on the outside, a darker color. And also in these smaller paintings, I want to create some nice lacing. That's why I'm also going to use the Vallejo Iridescent Pearl Medium. And in this case, I mixed it to a pearl blue. And that's the color I'm using now. How I mix that paint is one part Phthalo Blue by Winsor & Newton, one part Vallejo Iridescent Pearl Medium, and two parts Pouring Medium. And the consistency, yeah, that's very difficult to explain. It's not thick as cream, but also not thin as water. Yeah, I think it's warm honey. And some paints are thicker than other paints, so that's why I add in some paints a little bit of water to get it to the right consistency. So the next color is the Phthalo Blue. So one part paint and four parts pouring medium and a little bit of water to get it to like a warm honey consistency. And I also am going to add the website links to comparable supplies for the acrylic binder and the primer I'm using. And I didn't test those comparable supplies because I can't buy them here. But also Friona Art has listed them in her description box. And I checked the ingredients and they are the same as I'm using, so yeah, I think it will work. And it's a combination of primer, binder and the Vallejo pearl medium to get that nice lacing effect. So this color is the pearl white, the same mix as the pearl blue, two parts pouring medium, one part paint, the titanium white in this case by Winsor & Newton, and one part Vallejo pearl medium. And a lighter shade of blue, and this is the Amsterdam acrylic turquoise blue. So all different shades of blue and one bright color, and that will be the permanent magenta. Yeah, these squeeze bottles are not airtight, so sometimes there gets a film in the squeeze bottle. So I take it out, and then it will work again. there you can see it, taking it out of my squeeze bottle. Yeah, this is the permanent magenta. I think that will look nice with all those colors, a nice bright color in it. And so you can see I'm not that precise because I also want to see what kind of effect I'm getting with that. All the materials I'm using are listed in the description box of this video, but also at the end of the video with all the color names, the links to the websites. So if you're curious, go check out the description box. And also in this case, I'm going to use a paper napkin, a smaller one because I have a small canvas. So I'm going to do it the same way as Fiona R does, spraying it wet with a little bit of water. You can see it there. And just as I do with a plastic sheet I normally use, I'm going to place this on top of the acrylic paint. Very carefully. And then I press it very gently into the acrylic paint, so not much pressure. Only to make sure that the paper napkin touches the acrylic paint. Now I'm taking the corners, lifting them and holding my hand in the middle. There you can see it. And very carefully I'm lifting the paper napkin. And then this is what I get. The colors go very well together. I'm already getting some nice lacing effects, and that's all because of the Vallejo pearl medium, but also the combination of the acrylic binder and the primer, the torch for the air bubbles. And at the end of this video you will see two close-ups, one right after pouring but also one 24 hours later. And then we can see if the flower changes or not. I hope it will not, because I like it very much. And I also want to mention that I still have some promo codes with nice discounts. I am an affiliate of Jackson's Art Supplies. It's a UK based company. And if you order through my links that are in the description box and you are a new customer, you get 10% discount on your total order. So that's great. But I also have some promo code of resins companies. And the first one is Still Stone Coat Countertops. You get $10 discount on your $100 order. But I also have a promo code by Resin Pro, also a UK-based company, a different countries in Europe. And if you are there and you use my promo code Petra, then you get also 10% discount. So that's great. So and I earn a little bit of money out of that. So And I want to thank the people that already buy through the links. So this is the close-up directly after pouring. But you can't see it that well, so I will make another close-up right after pouring, and I will show it you in a minute. So this will be a better close-up, I hope. I want to show you the nice lacing effects I got from the pearl white, but also the pearl blue. The colors go very well together. Such a great idea of Fiona to use these supplies together and then get these effects. Yeah, it's really nice. And I love to use this technique with acrylics. Yeah, and the magenta looks very nice also in this, with the blue shades. Yeah, I need to work on the shape of the flower a little bit more. But yeah, I like the effects very much. Yeah, it's very nice. So this is a close-up after 24 hours of drying. It's already dry on the outside, and I must say it dries very shiny. It looks like there is a varnish layer on it, but it's not. It's the supplies combined together, so that's great. And also the flower didn't change. I still have the nice lacing. Yeah, maybe the colors are a little bit brighter. I like that. So what I already mentioned, I will do a series of these flowers on smaller canvases. And yeah, I hope you like that idea. Let me know what you think of it and what you think of this flower. For the people that haven't subscribed yet, consider to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up for this video, because that will help my channel a lot. All the information about where I buy my materials is in the description box, with the links to the websites and also the link to my Facebook and Instagram, my Amazon influencer store. So I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!